Nothing relevant.
Hey, can you come back to the office?
Yeah, sure, whatever.
I don't think she was talking to us. I think she was talking to Tsubasa.
That's a little dicey in group chat if you don't. If you don't just put a name down and be like, you just start spouting out random nonsense in a group chat. You're like, who are you talking to? Oh, sorry, wrong group. Mamori?
Hmm?
I think her name's Mamori? Yeah!
Just memories.
Mamori has a cooking show.
Mm.
It's just called Cooking with Mamori. No, Microwaving with Mamori.
Microwaving?
Yeah. She doesn't know how to cook very well. But it's more like the show is kind of like directed at like shut-ins and neats. So of course they don't know how to cook, but maybe they can run a microwave. So
who can't?
So I think that one's what it's more targeted at. It's just those kinds of people, like, Futaba, you don't know how to use a microwave? Although Futaba, I could probably believe a lot more since she, like, barely left her room.
Yeah. I still need to finish my second playthrough of Persona 5.
It's hard to do, like, fitting in games and other stuff in.
Mm-hmm.
Like I said, I still need to finish Curse of the Moon.
Octopath comes out next month.
Yeah. I started up just Shapes and Beats.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Nice. How's that?
I like it. I can only play, like, a couple of stages at a time. Because as much as I'm trying to focus on everything, I think it's the high contrast, and it just burns my eyes out way too fast. And maybe there's a setting to play in, like, the lower contrast kind of mode, but yeah, I'm, like, trying to focus on everything and, like, pay attention, and it just, like, tires me out really fast for some reason, more than, like, any other kind of game.
Yeah.
I haven't played Hyrule Warriors in a while.
God, there's so much stuff to do in that.
Yeah, I've gotten through 2 whole adventure maps.
Holy cow. Good lord. Well, is there any reason to do the adventure map besides unlocking stuff?
The adventure map will get you your other characters, but then there's higher tiers of weapons that you unlock.
Oh yeah, that's what I meant. Like weapons and...
There's...
Like I unlocked Zelda's... I know it said level 4, but the weapon says plus after it. Is it actually a plus, or is it the level 4? Like it's... Glitter Rapier Plus.
I think that one's just That one might be a level 4. I don't know. I haven't even locked those.
I unlocked that one because Brittany uses Zelda. And it was a huge pain in the butt to do.
Oh, I'm sure. Because you probably skipped to... Let's see.
I don't know if the levels are different.
No, it is a level 2 weapon.
Glittering Rapier Plus?
Yep.
No, it's level 4.
Level Glittering Rapier...
I think it's a Glittering Rapier.
...is a level 2 weapon.
What's the attack on it? That's 500 attack.
I don't know, I'm trying to find more information on it. Maybe it is a 4. Maybe, I guess 4 adds a plus to it.
Yeah, the plus was what was new about it, because I had lots of glittering rapiers.
Do you know the photographer? Yeah, he's pretty famous. I've worked with him before. Man of true talent brings the true beauty of his subjects. Or at least, that's what they say. If you ask me, it's all thanks to the models, not the guy that's taking the shots. I used to be a fashion model. I bet you did.
Yeah.
For Victoria's Secret. Yeah, I don't know.
I don't know how to tell, because I guess they don't have... Oh, I guess it's actually a Gleaming Rapier Plus. It looks like the Gleaming Rapier. But the wiki doesn't give me much information about it.
No.
On the map, it had a level. It had LV4 next to the unlock.
Yeah.
I haven't unlocked any level 4 plus ones that I know. Well, I know I haven't.
Level 4 plus weapons are identical to level 4s, except they'll have a rainbow colored background, a new name, an alternate color when used in battle, and a secondary element icon under their main one.
Oh, it's two elements? Yeah, that's interesting. What is level 4s, though? Because the level 4 I unlocked was just a Glimmering Rapier Plus.
So unless it was just kind of like a rare drop that rolled a plus on it to boost the stats of it.
Well, I got it from beating the mission with A rank.
Hmm.
And it said level 4 on there, so I assume that's how I unlocked level 4 weapons.
Yeah.
For that person.
Yep.
So that's why I did it, but... I wasn't paying attention to all I know what I'm supposed to be doing.
You have to go somewhere else. Oh, you're gonna go be... You have to go find Tsubasa. She's going to a photo shoot, and you're going to the photo shoot to be her bodyguard or something?
Yeah, I just saw Tsubasa earlier. She was trying to start running to a telephone pole, and then she apparently apologized to it. It's worse than I thought.
Yeah. Super anxiety Tsubasa.
Okay, I'm going to Daitama. So yeah, I've done about 25% of the adventure map.
And of one of the adventure maps?
No, of like the first one. Isn't the first one called... What's the first one called?
First one's just like the normal adventure map.
Yeah, I thought that one was called adventure map.
Yeah, so you've done a quarter of it.
I've done a quarter of adventure map. And then I've done about a quarter... If I didn't have to, I wouldn't. done about a quarter of the Twilight map. Because that's the one that had the level 4 weapon for Zelda.
Mm-hmm.
But I had to go, like, it's right there, like, at the beginning, like, 4 squares away. But to get the item to search for it, I had to go all the
way across the map. Yeah, that's the shitty part.
And, so I got that, and I got a level 4 weapon for, Impa on the way. And then I've done maybe 20% of the Termina map. I was trying to unlock the Fierce Deity costume.
I did all of, well, I'm not going to say all of it, because there's still like a couple of squares that I haven't unlocked in like the adventure map, but I've basically done the entire map there. I did almost all of the Great Seas map. There's a mission on that one that I'm gonna have to come back to, because holy shit, that one's rough.
Dude, some of these missions, I feel like they'd be a lot harder in single player. With a second person, I'm like, golly, man. You gotta run all like back and forth across the map just to...
Well, that's why you use the command thing to...
But even then, you might have, like, maybe one person with you.
It's... The way I do it is when I start a map and I realize that, okay, I have, like, 3 or 4 other ones. Depending on the map size, like, the story mode maps, yeah, I'll send them to random places. When I'm doing the actual mission ones, it really depends, because I may have to play a mission like once or twice till I actually learn what I'm supposed to do, and they're like, okay, well, this person needs to go there, and I'll just leave them there.
Yeah.
There's other times where I use the command and they don't freaking move. They like they get stuck at like a group of enemies and they just don't run past them.
Yeah.
Yeah, I've had some weird things like that, but yeah, I beat basically those two, except for like maybe the last mission of the Great Seas map for a new Ganondorf weapon, I think it is. And that one is, fuck, man.
Yeah.
Oh no, it's for Young Link. I think it's a weapon for Young Link. It's Christ, that one's hard as shit, too. You have Young Link, and all you get is Young Link.
Hate those.
It's the map where you get the Master Sword. Mm-hmm. And...
Gotcha.
You have to... I forget what like the sub thing is in it.
Pepper, no.
You need to complete like a certain like submission or something like that in the regular mission to complete keep going to unlock the, like the final fight. And the final fight is with Skull Kid. And the whole thing is super rough because I think you have to use the opposite element. And then you're fighting Skull Kid, and it's just Shadow, so you can't really do much.
Yeah.
And I got through it. That one map took me like 25 minutes to finish that mission. And I got an A ranking on time. I got an A ranking on like, kills. And then I got a B for damage taken. And it's just because the enemies are all, they have a morale boost. They have like a double morale boost and like a shield boost. Mm. I was like, this is a little shit. This is hard.
Yeah.
And like, there's like no magic almost anywhere. Man, that's... Ah! So, yeah, I need to, like, level Young Link a little bit more. Maybe hopefully find some better weapons.
That's the worst part, I think, is it's really hard to keep everybody leveled. And it forces you. Like, I hate it when it's like, okay, you need to use Darunia. No!
Yeah.
Or Wizro. Wizro!
There's a map on the... There's a mission on the Great Seas map that's for Ganondorf only. And you can have... Well, it's for Ganondorf, and you can have other people in there. But it's... Fight the incarnations of Ganon.
Mm.
And it's... If you haven't played through the extra missions of story, that would be like the first time you see Shadow Ganon.
Mm.
So you fight Shadow Ganon, the Pig Ganon, and Demise.
I don't know if I've fought Shadow.
Or sorry, not the imprisoned. Mm. At the same time.
Which part of the story do you see Shadow Ganon? Because I haven't done Linkle or Sia's.
You have to, well...
Or is it when you continue on further?
You have to continue on into the Wind Waker.
Okay. Wait. Wind Waker. I don't remember that being in the story.
You may have to beat Sia and Linkle's stuff
okay.
to make that unlock.
Okay.
But the Wind Waker is after, like, all the main story. There's, like, 4 or 5 more missions after that.
Okay.
The last mission of the Wind Waker one is pretty hard, too.
The last thing I did was, in the story, was beat the Pig Ganon.
Okay. So, yeah, you get to that mission, and it's like, beat Pig Ganon, Shadow Ganon, and the Imprisoned all at the same time. You have 10 minutes.
Jeez. Dude, there's one that we did last night that was... Or not last night, but... But there was a mission where... I don't know if you've done any of these. I think I've only seen them on the Twilight map. But it's like, use your tactics to work together is what it says or something like that. And what it is you have to beat... There'll be, like, at least 2 enemies that spawn. And you have to beat both at the same time.
All these people are tired. Oh, no.
So, like, the first time you see it, it's not too bad. It's like, defeat 2 Dark Lizalfos at the same time. And you're like, okay. And then just more spawn, like, defeat 2 dark moblins, defeat. But there was one last night where it was like, defeat 2 dark links at the same time. Okay, now defeat 2 dark sheiks at the same time. Okay, now defeat 3 dark gearhims at the same time. Oh, God, it was so hard.
Man.
So hard.
That's rough.
It is. And... If you're not hitting them all at the same time, they heal each other.
Dang.
And I think I had to use Ganon.
Mmm.
Yeah, I was forced to use Ganon.
I like his trident.
I haven't even unlocked that yet. Maybe that would be better than his swords. I like the swords. But every single one of his heavy attacks is super slow.
Yeah.
Super slow.
The trident is lightning based. A lot faster. It's kind of like changing from like Impa's like water sword to like the flame Naginata.
I haven't got that yet either.
I love Impa's Flame Naginata.
I think my favorite character to play as so far is Sheik.
Sheik has like a ton of stuff going on too.
Yeah.
The Shadow Photographer. God damn, dude, how far... Look at the fucking close-ups you would get with a freaking lens that long.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it's...
Yeah, but I don't even know what all her stuff does, but I like the different things you can do with her songs. Like, it feels like the water just makes you, like, avoid attacks for a little while.
Yeah, I don't remember what the water one does. I like the lightning one.
The lightning one's nice. The only thing I don't like about it is I wish it didn't knock people so far away.
That one is... It's not... That one's not for comboing people. That's for, like, trying to get kills as you're running to the next point. I think the one I like the most is the shadow one.
Which one?
The shadow.
Yeah, the shadow one's nice.
It's like, alright, you guys all stay right there. I'll come back to you in just a second.
I don't like the shadow combo, though. The shadow heavy attack.
It's, or the drop down from the death from above.
It takes too long to go, so half the time it doesn't hit. And I don't like the light combo either. Because the same reason, she takes too long to play the thing at the end.
Yeah.
Which is not terrible. I don't know what the field on the ground does, though.
For the light one?
Yeah.
If I was going to guess anything, I would say, like, it enchants your weapon or something. You have to find... No, you have to... If you go down in between the cafe road... Like down that one on the right. No, go across that road. Yeah, it's the you can see it in the distance from the other one, but it's
down this one.
Down that one. I see. Look at all this peppy music. Everybody's tired. They don't want to listen to reincarnation.
Yeah.
Yeah, Impa's Flame Naginata is a lot of fun.
I like Impa's Water Sword. I really like her last heavy special where, like, the four water swords, like, drop down, and then she just grabs them and slashes with them.
Yeah.
It's really cool.
I
mostly just use Link, though.
Well, it's so easy to use Link because the Master Sword is overpowered for a good portion of, like, the starting maps and stuff. So it's like, that's who you go to, so that's who your main level is. And
not only that, just his basic Y attack just... murders the crap.
No, yeah, it's the width and the swing.
It's so easy to just rack up kill. Like every time you swing, you kill like 50 dudes.
I don't know. Well, like one of those girls on those photos looks like Chie from Persona 4.
I've never played Persona 4, so
I haven't either. But I know who Chie is. Resemblance wise, it's there, I think.
Yeah. Farja could get used to this kind of idolosphere. Really? I thought she'd be more into like a BDSM than me. I don't know.
Yeah. Yeah, so, like, the one right there, like, she's facing forward against the brick wall. Mm-hmm. Let me see if I can find it. So that's Chie. So it's like, that's the resemblance.
I can say it.
Guts to explode. So there's your gimmick. Don't walk in front of cameras.
Okie dokie. Cameras. So what kind of enemies we got here?
First strike.
Good.
I guess you just get him right now.
Is it a first strike then? Or...
Nah, I think it's just...
I wonder if it's because I changed your costume.
Maybe.
Oh, good. There's those guys there who are wrecking my life.
Well, stat-wise, they're still going to be tough, but they're not going to, like, completely destroy you.
Yeah, but now I might be able to find out what they're weak to while I'm not getting my
ass. Yes, very, very true.
solo. Two star.
I don't know if I've got any of those.
Yeah, you've been getting 2-star.
Uh-huh.
You should start seeing 3-star, I think, towards the end of this. Yeah, they're gonna be... At least you have something else to fall back on. Well, there you go.
Once you hit them with one weakness, you learn all their weaknesses, right?
No.
No.
Once you... I think once you kill them and exit the battle, then you learn everything. Get the fire and death.
Unfortunately, I don't have anything that combos off of that. Yet.
Nope. You're gonna want to swap Tsubasa back in at some point too. She's getting reduced XP.
She's getting reduced XP? Oh, well, I got her. Okay, so I'll switch her back in now.
Yeah, there you go.
That's why I switched her out, so Kiri can wake up. I needed to do one more fight. Dang it.
That happened on both of them.
I could have done her side quest without.
It's fine. That's what those intermission points are for anyway.
You can't miss out on them, can you?
No. Not unless you just like, nah, we're going through the story. Go, 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 go. If you do that, yes, you would miss out on them. But once you hit those intermission points, like, you're not... You shouldn't miss them. No, Bixby, I don't... What the fuck?
Let's see if this shows me these things now. It does. Alright.
You can just talk to him.
Oh, okay.
It's annoying, trust me. Too freaking huge! Freaking huge! Morpher strike.
Just one.
Yeah. Ooh. I don't know why he looks different. He got his item drop.
Sweet. Shaman.
But you've already had that one before.
I didn't have
Shaman.
Your
skill book, though.
What is that?
Skill book is, go and look at it. I think it should just give experience towards your Carnage weapon.
Oh, really? Wow. Just... I'm not wasting that on some low-level crap.
So, that's one of the best benefits of the DLC stuff in this game.
Mm-hmm.
Is that specifically plus the level books, the experience books. Like, those make, like, grinding out, like, weapons and, like, other things much, much easier. It's insane, like, how much it helps with certain points instead of, like, going through and, like, grinding everything out and... getting stuck. And they don't show up until you either unlock this place or, like, come in here the first time.
So you can get those at all until...
If you have the...
Unless the DLC?
If you had the DLC, you wouldn't be able to unlock those in the DLC stuff. Like, the DLC stuff doesn't even unlock until you come to this place.
Okay, gotcha. Do we have the DLC?
No.
Oh, okay.
You would have to either buy the DLC. You would have to buy the DLC. Because I've already used the codes on mine. So. But I don't remember. I think the DLC for this game is only like $10.
Not that worried about it.
That depends on whether or not the eShop is still available.
Oh, yeah. Sleeping Sand.
Elec Blizzard.